Please see the link in the description to download a worksheet for this video. We advise that you never look at the sun, since doing so could make you blind. If you have not already done so, we suggest that you view parts 1, 2, and 3 of this astronomy mini-series before watching this video. When the sky is very dark, we can see a long column of stars called the Milky Way galaxy. The stars in the Milky Way are our closest neighbors because we live in the Milky Way. A galaxy is a collection of stars, their planets, gas, dust, and other objects that are held together by gravity. Since we are inside the Milky Way, we cannot look at it from the outside. But astronomers think this is how it looks from far away, and that we are located in this region. There are about 100 billion stars in the Milky Way galaxy. Like our Sun, each star may have several planets that orbit it. We call planets outside of our solar system exoplanets. So far, astronomers have found over 5,000 exoplanets, but these are very difficult to see from far away, and astronomers estimate there are many more exoplanets. The stars of the Milky Way are spread out over a huge distance, which would be about this many miles across. Most of us don't know the words for numbers this big, so astronomers measure distances in time rather than miles. Using time to measure distance is a little like asking friends how long their bus ride is to school, rather than asking them how many miles away they live from school. Because light can travel about 6 trillion miles in 1 year, we call that distance 1 light year. Now, instead of describing the distance in a number of miles that is too big for common words, we can say that the Milky Way is about 100,000 light years across. When we look at other galaxies, many have shapes in motion that are similar to water draining from a bathtub. They often have a spiral shape with long arms extending from the center. Some look like plain disks, and so far, all of those that we have discovered rotate. Occasionally, a galaxy will not look like a spiral or a disk, so are called irregular galaxies, like this cartwheel galaxy. Astronomers suspect some of these irregular-shaped galaxies were made when two galaxies collided with each other. All the stars in a galaxy orbit around the galaxy's center. It takes our Sun about 230 million years to make one orbit around the Milky Way's center. Why do all the stars in a galaxy stay in that galaxy, rather than being flung off in various directions as they orbit the center? In the first video, we learned that the Moon orbits the Earth, because the Earth has more mass than the Moon. In the second video, we learned that the planets orbit the Sun, because the Sun has more mass than the planets. In both cases, objects with a large mass have a large gravitational pull on smaller objects. So, astronomers suspected that the center of galaxies must have objects with very high mass that are keeping the stars in the galaxy pulled towards the center. That's why they searched for and discovered black holes at the center of some galaxies, such as this one seen at the center of our Milky Way galaxy. This black hole has a mass equal to 4 million times the mass of the Sun, but in a small region of space. As the name suggests, black holes are black so they can be hard to see. But if matter, like a star or dust, is falling into a black hole, then that matter forms a bright accretion disk around the black hole. If black holes are not outlined by bright accretion disks, astronomers can still detect them in other ways, including by sensing their gravitational waves. This computer model shows two black holes merging. Although it's frightening to think about falling into a black hole, there are no black holes near the Earth, so we will never fall into one. Here's a summary of this section. Please pause the video if you wish to read this. In addition to stars, planets, and black holes, galaxies have large clouds of dust and gas called nebulae. Many of these nebulae are made of hydrogen, which is the lightest element. When enough of these gas clouds gather to create sufficient mass, the clouds collapse due to the force of their own gravity and condense into a new star. Smaller amounts of gas and dust may gather to form planets that then orbit that star. Other nebulae are formed at the end of a star's life cycle when a huge star, much bigger than our Sun, explodes in a process called a supernova. About 1,000 years ago, Chinese astronomers noted a bright object in the sky that could be seen during the day for several weeks. Modern astronomers have looked in the direction they described and found the Crab Nebula in the Milky Way. In the center of the nebula is a very bright but small object called a neutron star that is the leftover of a massive star that exploded. Neutron stars are so dense that a piece of a neutron star the size of a sugar cube has the same mass as a piece of the Earth the size of an entire mountain. The clouds around the neutron star are the rest of the star that exploded. Unlike the nebula we showed earlier that was mostly hydrogen and condensing to form a new star, this nebula contains different types of atoms. For example, the green colors represent oxygen atoms which may have been made by fusion when the star was together as one piece. As a reminder from the prior video, stars use fusion to merge two smaller atoms to make a bigger atom. For example, our Sun fuses two hydrogen atoms to make a helium atom, and in the process releases an enormous amount of heat and light. This process can continue such that atoms larger than hydrogen can fuse together to make even bigger atoms than helium, such as carbon and oxygen. This may explain how some of the oxygen atoms were made, that are shown as green in this nebula. But many other types of atoms in this cloud were likely made during the star's final explosion that blew it apart. Those atom types are colored dark blue in this periodic table of the elements. The elements that are in yellow boxes may be made when two neutron stars merge. If that neutron star was to merge with another neutron star, they would have a huge explosion during which they would form many new elements that would make up a new cloud like this nebula. Exploding and merging stars is a major way that elements are made and is called stellar nucleosynthesis. Some of the elements are then included in new stars and planets as they condense from nebulae, which is why those elements are on Earth. As you can see from this table, almost all the atoms in our bodies were made inside stars, or when stars were exploding or merging. We are literally made of star stuff. Here's a summary of this section. Please pause the video if you wish to read this. When we focus the Hubble Space Telescope on a part of the sky that is about this size, we can see more than 5,000 galaxies. Each galaxy has millions of stars. Astronomers estimate there are 2 trillion galaxies in the universe, so that means there may be this many stars in the universe, and each star may have several planets. Astronomers estimate that all of the stars, nebulae, and other visible matter make up only 15% of the total matter in the universe. A major clue is in pictures like this. This galaxy has been distorted, so there are now copies of it spread out over an arc. This distortion is called gravitational lensing and happens when there is a lot of mass between us and what we're looking at. Since we cannot see whatever is causing this distortion, we call it dark matter. This is thought to be different than black holes, which we also cannot see directly and have a lot of matter. We cannot detect dark matter on Earth. About 100 years ago, Edwin Hubble discovered that almost all galaxies are moving away from each other and from us. He determined this by noting what's called redshift, which is how light appears when it's moving away from us. This is the opposite of blueshift, which is how light appears when it's coming towards us. One way to remember that red means away is to think of red taillights that we see on cars that are moving away from us. We can even use red and blue shifting on a single object, like the Sun shown here, which shows us how it is rotating. About 25 years ago, astronomers discovered that the speed that galaxies are moving away from each other is increasing. As of now, it is unclear what the force is that is causing almost all galaxies to move away from each other at an accelerating rate. But astronomers use the term dark energy to describe that force. One way to imagine how galaxies could all get farther from each other is to think of each galaxy as a chocolate chip in a space made of dough that is being baked. Astronomers have many more tools today than they did even a generation ago, and throughout this video, we have included images obtained by many of these instruments. For example, in New Mexico, 27 huge antenna dishes coordinate their aim to form one large radio telescope. 330 miles above us, the Hubble Space Telescope orbits the Earth and sends us images that have been a key to multiple discoveries over the last 30 years. The James Webb Space Telescope started recording images in 2022 and was designed to detect things that Hubble cannot. LIGO is a series of facilities with very long perpendicular tunnels containing laser beams that can detect faint gravitational waves. Together, these tools help us better understand nature. Here's a summary of this section. Please pause the video if you wish to read this. Please subscribe if you'd like to be notified of future educational videos we make. Thanks for your attention.